That is one big sticker.
Oh, looky look. We're back looking at this. So, today's episode will be brought to you by Lindy Frauen. Never met the individual, but we hear nothing but good things. And I somehow feel like I've let people down. Like I didn't, you know, these are just videos of me doing things, and it's not necessarily how to. And I don't necessarily show every step that I take to solve each and every problem. It's more about just hanging out and, you know, this is it, right? This is entertainment. If you pick up a trick or you see something interesting, by all means. But anyway, taking the pickup out, checking the leads, doing all that, taking the pickup apart. Looking inside it, peeling all the tape off and checking the connections. So here's what happens. There's two things that happen. And this is, sometimes I have let people down, but you have to look at it from where I'm sitting. If this was my guitar, and I was at home, dicking around, and, you know, no cares in the world, and figured, well, I'll try and fix it. And I had success. And I did it all on my own time, my own tools, nobody else helped. And that's a great success. But when I'm doing work for other people, there's a different philosophy. And this is why, you know, it's just like, well, resolder that. And I go, no, it goes away. Because if it doesn't go away, it will come back again. And this is what I've learned over time. This is not a lesson I'm preaching about that has anything to do with other than experience. So, I had nothing to do. Okay, and I took the pickup out, and I unraveled the tape, and I found one little hair-like wire, yeah, and we reattached that, and it came back to life, but will it stay alive? I don't have that answer. So I could look like a hero after the fact and go, well, hey, I fixed it, here you go, and then a week later, or 2 weeks later, or a month later, it comes back. And now I'm the idiot. This is a $33 pickup. I looked it up. I got no time for that. I spent my own time fucking around with no guarantees, mind you. Okay, so that's the other thing. If I put a new pickup in, that's a guarantee. If I repair this, or start repairing it, or spend, you know, numerous minutes of the day trying to make that go again, and I get nowhere, well, what have I done? I've just wasted my time. I can't ask the person that I'm doing this for to go, oh yeah, you know, pay me for fucking around for an hour and a half. So that's why it's like, that's the way it is. Just so you know. And my camera's beeping again, and this is getting fucking crazy. And without further bullshit, we're going to get all this out of here. We're going to fix up the shielding stuff that was going on. Look, free picks. And we're going to make it all go. I'm actually going to put strings on it, set it up. All that marvelous stuff. I'm also waiting for pizza. Friday night. I haven't had pizza in a while. There's a good place not far. We'll even let them deliver it tonight. Sometimes I just go get it. Oh, there's that. And then we got this little handy guy here, which works great. Instead of trying to grab it,
with a set of pliers and mucking the hell out of it. But hey, we can do that too. So all that schwoz should just fall out of there. Oh, I gotta desolder the old pickups. What's left? Oh, output jack. And you guys. No star washer on the back. Well, we got a big bunch of hurt going on here. Let's look at the back first. Oh, we'll look at the front first. Okay, so we got a bunch of chunks of foam, and somehow the back cavity was having problems getting the pickup high enough, so it all spacer went in there. That's not the end of the world, but I would have glued that in anyway. But the whole shielding thing is get these little chiclets out of there. It never works if there's gaps and spaces and it's not all connected, which will be my next little test here, just to see if this has conductive adhesive and I won't have to redo everything. And it appears that when it overlaps, it conducts. So that's the first bit of good news for today. Right? Come on. Well, let's have a look at getting the shielding fixed up on that, but before I do this, I want to just look at this Lawler pickup and see what's going on with the mounting. And back to the mounting, all this foam and stuff, you should really be springs in there. And with a little bit of magic, I might just have some in my magical box of magic. Let's find out. Oh, well, let's look at the back. Hold on. Yeah, so it sort of got the same sort of thing where there's big gaps and it doesn't come up over the edge. And then the other thing that has to happen, where did that guy go? Oh, here he is. We got to put shielding tape all on the back side of that so it completes the box, so to speak. So what was I going to do? Oh, have a look at Lawler and see how they sit in there before we get all crazy about shielding. If that little piece of wood needs to go in there, well, we will put it in there, but we'll make sure it never comes out. Okay. Got a nice little flag on there that tells me that it's the bridge. And they do a little grounding lug. But the other thing that they provide, a really nice camera, probably can't get that, little countersink screws that instead of these big sons of bitches sticking up, those will all be nice and flush. That's just spectacular. So that's the bridge. Let's just carefully put it into the hole and see how much backing it really needs. Comparing these guys, comparatively speaking, they're the same height. I don't know. I guess I'm starting to think I know why. Because we didn't have the right stuff. So we just got by with what we had. And that's fine. Now this little tag wants to travel not in the direction I want it to go. I might just put a B on this for bridge. Come on, you can do it. Get in there. I'll never get this out after. And actually, what am I doing? There is a simpler way to do this. There is. Hold on. A little bit of math. I get talking and I stop thinking. So, the screws pop out a, I'm going to say, let's say a quarter inch, just to be happy. And the cover itself is 5/8 of an inch. So 7/8 of an inch is what I need underneath that guy. Well, of course it's a nice tight fit. That's easier than wrestling the pickup. We'll just play with the cover. Now I need a little bit of a straight edginess here. Sorry, I'm over here, folks. I'll be right back. And we're going to go across the top of the fretboard. And the pickup will never need to be higher than that. So I'm seeing this guy wants to sit up. If I wanted to get it that high as it could absolutely go. Which is right there. And then add a quarter inch to that and subtract it from underneath. I should be able to figure out how long the springs are that I need. But let's just cut to it and get the box of junk out. Yeah, I don't think we need that. It's not at all. And just so you know, Ed, I'm jacking you for your sticker. Okay, so now we're cooking. And all I have to do is do the back side of that guy. And I'm just going to, yeah, let's just do the back side and on it goes. Yeah, so that's going to complete that quite nicely. And the other side's all sussed out. So what'll happen with these pickups, and would have happened with the other pickups, this braid is connected to ground, and that braid is going to touch the copper as it travels through both cavities, and both pickups are going to touch this copper. So we don't have to worry about running an extra wire through here. And the other thing that's going to happen is I am going to find some springs and use the screws. So the screws and the springs themselves are going to make contact with the copper shielding, and also help make that ground that we all know and love. I'm fairly happy with that, and I didn't even cut my fingers. All right, let's get the pickups installed. Okay, so this is where I'll get dicked here, because the new screws are all really nice and skinny compared to these fat fuckers that were on the other pickups. So what's probably going to happen is when I try to remount these, those screws are just going to go. See? Yeah, you know, it's always easy, right? Everything's easy. We'll fix that right now. So I found a couple of nice, big, fat, beefy springs. They're probably going to be way too fucking long. But I would rather have something. See, and I think those are even way too long. I think I want to use those for the back. Okay, now I'm getting an idea. Well, my once proud and mighty magical box of shit is pretty much getting depleted. Years and years of collecting odd bits and parts, one at a time. What did I do with the other brand new pickup? Oh, it's right here in front of me. Here we go. Like I said, that's spring loaded now. Much, much better. No issue. And this guy here, same deal. Oh, I gotta put that one in there. Of course, ruining the shielding on the other side at the same time. Oh, that's because I didn't beat that hole through the shielding at all. Where is it? Where are you? Come out. Is that you right there? There you are. That'll work better. Let me get that guy out of there like that. We could, it's about time maybe to get rid of some shit here off the bench, I think. Or maybe not. Let's just keep going. And then, as I notice here, all the star washers are gone off of those too. So we need those guys. That's, you know, it might seem like extra parts at the time. Let's see if I've got four of those. Uno. See, the magic parts box. I got a big bag of these somewhere, so I'm not too worried about those. But, you know, like all this shit makes a difference. So it's destined to fail. Because what'll happen is the controls themselves will loosen and then they'll turn inside the cavity, and then the lugs on the control pots will touch the copper, and then it won't work anymore. And you'll be standing there like a stooge, going, my guitar don't buckle back. Okay, four of those. Let's plunk this back into its hole. So I was reading about these, and they're reverse wound, so in the center position, hey, we're good. Okay, I'm gonna find the other parts and get strings on it and clean up some tools. And that's sort of the end result of that. And I will say this much, this little plug to get the switch out of the way, that ain't so bad when you're in there wiring, because you can just go click and it's gone, instead of another gangling of wires to try and pull out of the way. So that's it. Lid goes on. Carefully put that guy in there. The new shielded box is complete. Okay. Big old set of guitar strings here. Just for your Ernie Balsack 9s. In case anybody cares. You guys have seen me do that trick a million times, just till I get a couple of strings going. Now, someone decided to replace the nut on this. I take no credit for that. None whatsoever. So I'm gonna get both E strings bobulated here. And go, baby, go. You can do it. Okay, you get where I'm going here. We'll be there in a second. Just having a little check see here and make sure none of the strings are biting on the back side of the bridge. That's all good, so the stop bar can stay down. String action looks pretty close, just for starters. I guess I better tune it up. Maybe stretch the strings a little bit. Yeah, okay. You may remember, I made the truss rod really straight, the neck really straight, because the strings were off it for a while. And now that we put strings back on it, the neck relief is not enough. So, let's open up that old can of worms again. And see what's going on. Oh, this is the one that has two screws, but only one screw actually does anything. Classic. Memory tells me that it's this one. We want a little bit of lefty loose action. Try a quarter turn. See what happens. And as always, we'll double check all this nonsense later.
Tiny bit more. I always take the truss rod off because I want the strings to reorient themselves. So we're almost at the point where the truss rod probably isn't doing its job. It's getting pretty loose. So the guitar itself tells me that really doesn't like these light strings at all. I'm going to loosen it right off and just see where we end up. But the other thing too is that it hasn't had strings on it for a while. So don't freak out right away. Freak out later. That's what I always do. Okay. Well, it's still sort of tensioned. But you can sort of tell it's not really doing anything. I'm just pissing in the wind at this point. Okay, so I just loosened it off so it's barely engaged at all. And that's given me 12th thou of relief when I fret it the last fret. And yeah. Stop there. You're seeing I got this new fancy fucked up neck rest thing, and this part is really nice, but what it doesn't do very nice that my other one used to do is if you want to slide the guitar across the bench, this one likes to fall over. So I'll get used to that, but it does offer a little more, you know, lateral support to the neck itself. And for what it cost, I went. But like I said, I'm so used to my other one, which has a wider footprint, and you just slide the guitar and everything slides. But this one, ank, be careful, Dave. Be careful. All right, so what kind of trouble did I get into there? We set the neck relief. Let's set the string action. Check the intonation and check it all again and then stop, I guess. Okay, so the folks at Gibson would have you believe that at the 12th fret, somebody was asking me this, what fret, every guitar is different, check the manufacturer, that we would want to see 5/64ths, and right now it's at 4. While I'm cracking off about things, yeah, Gibson would want you to have 5/64ths on the low E and 3/64ths on the high E. And we are microns away from that. Just microns. So, you know, out of all the scientific methods and measuring devices and shit that they've come up with, the ruler's still your best friend. So, a little bit of pickup height. I don't think we want to get much closer than that. And at that point, I think we're running out of... We're running out of screw and we're running out of spring underneath. So before they fall right out of the guitar here in a second. And I am just eyeballing this. I shouldn't do that because my eyeballs are fucking shot. This dangly mess just waiting to scratch something. Yeah, so that's too close. Too close. So what I'm looking for is a gap of 1/8 of an inch. There's got to be a better way than this little keychain of shit here. It's going to come back up a hair. Try this side. Once again, dunk it down into the guitar.
see what my eyeball told me and what was actual reality. Weren't even close. Well, it was close, but there, that's nice. And that one, that would be too high as well, where my eye was telling me, yeah, go for it, go for it. We unfuckulated it. Totally. I still gotta do a little intonation thing on this, which could turn into a total nightmare. Okay. Thanks for hanging out. I hope everybody, sometimes everybody goes longer videos, shorter videos, less bullshit, more bullshit. I don't know anymore. I'm just doing this for fun, guys. Cheers.